Three, two, one. Let's talk about S, baby. Let's talk about you and me. Let's talk about all the good things and the bad things that may be. Let's talk about S. Get your mind out of the gutter, people. You know, the word we're talking about, the word that starts with the letter S today, is sanity. The word sanity has been on my brain all week, man. We've been working on the academy this week and putting together the courses for the 7-day program, which I'll share with you guys in another video. It's really exciting. But one of the days is a personal development day where we bring these entrepreneurs in and walk them through how to handle burnout, how to handle loneliness, how to deal with, you know, physical and mental health and well-being. And so I've been thinking a lot about it, and so many of the young startups that I mentor, they don't think about mental health or physical health or even well-being and sanity until much later in the game, because it's not something that you're taught how to deal with or train. You know, we're taught how to be engineers and doctors and computer scientists and chefs, but how are we taught the skills of, you know, maintaining a sanity? And for me, the way I looked at it and the way I coach when I talk to young startups is there is challenges and fears. And this is, again, a small portion of a bigger conversation. But, you know, the two things I want to talk about is challenges and fear. And most of us know, once something is a challenge, our system creates a process of dealing with it. Cash flow, relationship, car trouble, whatever your challenges are in a single day. Once you know this is my challenge, and you put a name to it, a title to it, and an emotion to it, you go about solving the challenge. You go about solving the challenge. But fear, on the other hand, is completely an emotional thing. And what I try to coach every time I work with a startup is, how can the founders take fears and then accurately map it to a challenge? So, for example, you know, I'm coaching somebody and their fear is, if we don't make payroll and we don't get new clients, I'm gonna lose everything I worked extremely hard for. I'm gonna lose my company, I'm gonna lose my business, I'm gonna lose my reputation. And the fear was so big that he didn't recognize the time that he has and the challenges that he can solve once he breaks it down. And once we took that big emotional problem and narrowed it into small challenges. I don't have a sales process to drive revenue. I don't have an HR process to handle these kind of payroll issues. I don't have a client strategy for referrals or lead generation. It was easy to go, man, in the next 3 months, before you run out of money, let's take your fears, turn it into challenges, and then a strategy to attack those challenges. Sounds super simple, because it is. When you remove emotions from your fear and turn it into a challenge, we're already taught to set up how to solve challenges. And so, word of the day, Fireside Friday, S for sanity. I urge all of you to think about, what are some of your fears and can you convert them to challenges? And I urge all of you to have open conversation with people that you love about your fears, because if it's too much and you can't actualize it, reach out to somebody. Call me, I'll help you figure out how to take your fears and turn it into challenges, and then give you another day to fight and live your dreams. As always, lots of love. It's your boy, Sats.B. Oh, thank you. Oh, thank you very much.
You're welcome.